out this morning for casted salmon, and I'm going to be a bit troubled by the sun, I suspect. And also, the river isn't just as high as you would like it to be. It's certainly fishable, but you know, I'd like another 2 or 3 inches in it. But this is about the first time this year that it has been up to a fishable height at all. So you make the best of what you get. Sun has been out and bright, but there's a wee taste of cloud coming. And again, that always gives you hope. In this height of water, the fish in this pool are probably a wee bit further up the pool generally, but I thought we'd give this an investigation before I go up there. Caught a bit of weed. So, I've started off on a red shrimpy thing and a small silver stoat as well. Everything quite small, you know. So what I'll maybe do is nip across the fence here and fish the streamier water at the top, because in this height of water, it's usually a better bet than down here. The fish seem to move up the pool as the water drops. And the water's, well, oh, I think that was a trout. The water's a few inches sort of thinner than I would like to see it. So I'd expect this to be fishing over where the fish are lying today, or certainly in the current height of water. But I think I'm also going to need a scoosh of the anti-midge stuff, because just because it's sheltered in here in the wee valley, they're having me. There's a wee breeze has come up, and you kind of hope, well, Yeah, that'll put them down, you know. So, what I'm going to do is put some anti-midge cream on first, or just because I've no choice but to fish in this wee valley a bit, and there's a few of them about. So, I think I've got a bit of weed. There must still be weed coming down the river, you know, with the again with this being the first rise up. All season, there hasn't been much water, so let's see if I've got midge cream here. I'll have to go back to the rucksack for it. I usually have some in a pocket. You see, midge scoosh. So some anti-midge scoosh on us now. See if that improves our day. Maybe improve the concentration. Basically this year I've fished for brown trout. I think I've caught a wee bit of weed again. Basically this year I've fished for brown trout. So I haven't been fishing for salmon at all. And it takes a wee while to get into the, I don't know, the mood of it, I suppose, is maybe the one. The change, you know. So that's where I want to be. Again, caught some old rubbish coming down, yeah. I might have to review my tactics. I have the intermediate on, but really the floater would do me. So maybe a change to that would be helpful. Caught some weed. I mean, I think the weed's just sailing down the river because it's the first time the river has had a wee clean out this year. There must be a lot of other rubbish coming down it. So I'll persevere with this for another few minutes, then move to the floater, see if that makes any difference. I don't think it will. I think the weed is actually floating down the river. It's not that I'm snagging the bottom. It's just that there is so much weed in the river. I think this is the world's best salmon, Paul. I am, of course, biased in that I just happen to like it, and I appreciate other people like other stuff. But, like I say, it's a wee bit low today, so that's... But, the river closes soon. The season's nearly over. So this is kind of, might be the only chance I get to fish it this year. And while it's low, there must be fish in it, you know. And there's always a wee chance. I've got to say, I've been having an utterly tragic year trout fishing. I literally can catch nothing. So I think it would be good if we got some rain and could get a few days at salmon just for something a bit different, because I've no idea why I'm catching nothing, but it's just been terrible. I mean, like everybody else, I have good days and bad days and all that stuff, but this year I'm just consistently making a complete pig's ear of it, really. A wee breeze now, and there's actually a few wee spits of rain in the wind. So, what I may do is go up and try the very streamy water right at the top. Is that in the reeds? No, I don't think so. The really streamy water right at the top here. Now, I've never had any joy in it at all. But then normally I would only come here when the water's a wee bit higher than this, you know. But this is fishable, so can't complain. So I've never done so well from up here. It's usually lower down the pool that I have the success, but with the water being relatively low, there might be a few fish up here, you know, either waiting to run, because this has been the first really runnable water there has been in a very, very long time, or just moved up into the streamier water because they like it, you know, takes their fancy maybe. So I think what I'm going to do is move to the floating tip. I think I'm fishing a bit too deep here. Just doesn't feel right, you know, in this weight of water. So I think I'm going to move to the floating rather than the intermediate. Not that the intermediate takes you down very far, but when you're fishing quite slowly like this in a river, it does actually make a difference, you know, whereas on the loch where the retrieve's quite fast, the difference is only an inch or two. But because the line's actually in the water quite a long time when you're fishing like this, it does make a difference, you know. So I think that's what I'll do. Because you see, that was quite deep. Took me to pull that up from a long way. And that's not really where I want to be. I've got the banana on the go and I've stopped for a bit of tea. Apart from anything else, the cloud has cleared at the minute and there's not really much point putting a whole lot of effort into fishing in the sun, you know. But I may fish down this pool once more, maybe. Just because there's nobody else about, nobody else out, so there's no reason not to give it another wee bash down, you know. I don't have a lot of river above it to myself, but it's just a wee fraction on the low side, you know. Another 6 inches of water would be what I need, you know. But the thing is, the rain stopped last night, like about 11 o'clock, and of course I couldn't get out this morning. This river runs off really fast. I have no doubt that it was probably in good condition about, you know, 2-3 o'clock in the morning. But it's just a wee fraction low now. But still, possibility, you know. And I mean, there's got to be fish here. And this is the first water there's been all year, so it's the only chance, you know, you take what you get. So I'll give it a wee throw, but I'm going to have a cup of tea first and finish the banana out. And we'll see where we go from there. Got to say, it's a lovely autumn morning. You know, you don't get many days like this in the year. I'm walking up the river now. Like I say, I'm going up to, there's a wee pool up here. Now, I'll not fish if the sun's on it, but sometimes fish is a wee bit lower than the one I've just left. Just as I was leaving that previous one, I nearly fell into the river because one of these fighter airplanes went past at about 35 feet. And the shock of the noise nearly caused me to tip into the river. What a job those boys do, like, flying those things. I don't know anything about them. I don't even know what sort of plane it was or what sort of plane they have. All I can tell you is it was grey. but what a fantastic job they do, you know, up there. And they come flying past occasionally. And scare the willies out of old people like me. One day, fishing the loch, going up a bit, there's a kind of hillside opposite it, and I was standing on the loch, and one of these jets went over my head, like I don't know, I think if I'd been casting at the time, I'd have taken the top off my rod. And of course, when he came to the hill, he had to climb up and over it, and when he did that, his mate must have been coming the other way. And the two of them nearly collided. I mean, I don't know, they turned the plane sideways. And I suspect if they hadn't, the wingtips would have touched. They were that close. It was just, that's fantastic to watch these things. But I was thinking, although they were, you know, they were a quarter of a mile from me when this happened, I thought, well, you know what, that sort of speed, there knows the distance, the wreckage will be spread over. It'll be pretty hard to explain somebody with a fishing rod in the wreckage. And sometimes if you're standing up on the coast, they go out to sea and stand them on their tail and go straight up, you know, and on a day like this, disappear into the clouds. It's fantastic. And I mean, I'm sure there's somebody in a camper van or hundreds of people in camper vans currently writing letters of complaint to the MOD to say, oh, you shouldn't be allowed to do this, you know. Pilot maybe had a sausage in his sandwich, and that invaded my vegan radius or some other rot. But even though it nearly caused me to fall in the river, I say more part of them. It's fantastic to see. And it's a great display for people like me to see just what these things can do, you know. Really, I don't imagine anybody stupid flies one of them. Because I don't know what's involved in flying one, but it's clearly not a simple job, you know. So, and it's funny, they're not always here. Some years you get loads of them, and some years none at all. So, and that's the first one I've seen in a couple of years, which I guess is why I nearly fell in. It's fantastic. So that's made my day. I don't think any fish are going to make it, mind you. But don't know, if we got some thicker cloud, might have a wee chance. Dear. You can tell I'm old, puffed out. I'll fish this bit of the river below me on the way down. But I'm going to walk up and fish down, I think. That's my plan. So we have a wee shower of rain, and while we also have the wee bit of cloud, I thought I would get the fly out quickly. Because this pool, I don't know, I have a feeling the fish is better in lower water than the one we started on. It's kind of... So I'm going to keep moving down it fairly quickly in the meantime until I can develop a plan. Did I catch the bank? No, maybe not. Oh, that's a wee tug. I think it was a wee trout. So She Who Must Be Obeyed has very kindly provisioned me with one of those twirl bars. And as you can see, there's a wee burn here and I have to get across it. And getting across it isn't just simple because it's extremely deep and a bit tricky to get across. But I want to go across and fish this wee run here at the top of this pool, because there's often a fish off the top of that. That's a wee islandy bit out there. I don't know if that's clear. It probably isn't clear, but and there's often a fish off the top of it in the wee run, and again with the water so low, maybe the broken water is a better place to be. So I think I'll go up and bash my way down that once I've had my twirl bar and a wee sit down, and I might even think about another cup of tea, you know. I made my way across the wee burn, and I didn't do too badly getting across it. Didn't actually end up in the burn. Don't know how deep it is. I must put the fly rod on at some point and see. I'll take a quick run at some of the wee pools up here, and then I'll fish the top of the one that I sort of came up to fish. Quite a stiff upstream breeze now, I suppose, compared to what I had, certainly. And you think I had midges in the morning. Wee wren. Flip, flip, flip. Oh, and a wee squeak. Yes. So I changed the fly. Red shrimpy thing, and a very tiny silver stoat type thing. Just because the water's not high, so big flies don't seem to be necessary. Wind's in my face here, so it's a wee bit trickier than I'd hoped. But on the other hand, that's the way it goes. And it gives me a wee wave on the water at the top of the wee island down there. And it just, you know, just might be enough. So what I'm going to do now is move down. There's like a boggy bit here that really requires manoeuvring around. So I'm going to move down past it and then fish down onto the top of the islandy bit. And then I'll jump back over the wee burn and make my lunch, I think. I think these are the priorities for the day. Because it must be nearly 1 o'clock, you know. So we'll do that. See how it goes. Down another wee step, maybe. This looks like it's going to fall into the river, so I'll just stand back a bit, because we've just had the first flood basically of the season, and I mean it's not a big flood, but you don't want to find yourself standing on something that isn't anything is on its way to falling into the river, you know. There's a sheep here that's taking a sudden interest in me. It's like, oh, what's this? Hey lads, look at this. Weirdness going on over here. Don't know what he's doing. He'll maybe shout advice. Well, she'll maybe shout advice in a minute. Like, oh, I wouldn't fish there, mate. Step, I think. I'm nearly at the wee burn now, so soon we'll cross it and call it lunchtime. That was messy. I can't believe that, but he took it right on the surface too. He's not a big fish. But I'm going to try and put him onto the reel just for convenience. Weeds much if I can avoid it, especially not with two flies on, you know. Oh, hey, don't like that. I think he's got the line wrapped around himself a bit now. So oh well, he's determined to head upstream. So it's quite a good fight in him for not a big fish, you know. Take the check down a wee bit. Get the net ready. He's got wrapped around. Now, he definitely isn't foiled hook. He took the fish at the fly well, but he's since got wrapped around the rest of the setup. Let's see if he'll come. Oh, no, I'm not. But it turns out that I think he's foil hooked, so he doesn't count. Go and try and find somewhere to put it back in without me getting an after him. There, oh, wait, like the clobber. So he was actually foul hooked. So, I was sure I saw the fly in his mouth at one point, but certainly by the time he got to me, it wasn't. So there we go. This doesn't look especially promising in view of how little flow there is on it, but again, seems a shame to just wander past it and not at least give it a wee quick cast. I think I'm going to need to strip the flies back and whatnot, keep everything moving. But you never know, fish might just pick up on it. I'm tangling all these rushes. Yeah, it's a pain. There's all sorts of siren noises going on. And I've no idea why. Today's Thursday, boy. Today Thursday? I don't know. I don't know what day it is. Sometimes they test the fire brigade sirens and stuff on Thursdays. Well, there's such experimentations. Came twice. Wee tiny brown trout. There's all sorts of sirens and experimentations going on. And as it has been going on for about 10 minutes, I'm going to guess they're testing something. They tend to do that a lot, you know. And it confabulates you. Right, I think I've had enough of this. Let's move on. I've come back down here, give it another wee try. Can't see that it's going to make any difference, but... well, do what you can. In this sort of lower water, I think the fish do sometimes come on to this side. I mean, mostly they're over on the other side, but I have kind of taken fish and the flies back like that, you know, out of under the bank. So I changed the point fly to like a very red shrimpy thing, just in case. still got the Barvis Crippler on the top, and I'll just fish down a wee bit further, and I think pretty much that'll do me. I think the water's a shade too low for the fish to be down there, but you never know. Fish don't always listen to me. So I think I've given that a good bashing down. And I think that'll do me for today. I don't really hold much hope of suddenly seeing fish. So I'll just wrap it up and call it done, because it's another 10-15 minutes to the car, you know.